Merlin put on his sunglasses, as if that would somehow shield him from the glare of his own misanthropy. Bunch of knuckle-dragging mouth breathers, the cantankerous voice in his head groused as a street preacher across the way yelled, "If you would just listen to me!" Before furrowing his brow and thumbing wholly determined through his King James Bible as a young woman wearing a t-shirt proclaiming, "I believe in unicorns," wandered past Merlin, pulling on her dreadlocks and chattering into her smartphone about how her dreads help her listen to Jah, as she looked away from a passed-out homeless man, drooling on yesterday's newspaper pillow. Meanwhile, a morbidly obese man carrying a bag of fast food seeped along in front of him, and a hunch-shouldered, hands jammed in his jeans 20-something sauntered aimless and alone. The brim of his camouflage cap pulled so far down that his face was entirely obscured, as he presumably counted chewing gum stains on the sidewalk, upon which he slacked at the dust. Not watching where he was going, the 20-something in the camouflage cap almost collided with another pedestrian, some striding douchebag in a sweaty suit who alerted him with annoyed, "Watch it!" The 20-something in the camouflage cap stopped short and glanced up, reflex unplugging his hand from his pocket in order to hide the now visible scar tissue on his neck and lower face from offending the eyes of the douchebag in the sweaty suit, who happened to glimpse the burn scars anyway and startle away. However roaring with cynicism Merlin's ill mood had been, his abject contempt flipped immediately into the deepest, most heartbreaking compassion at the sight of the 20-something in the camouflage cap's single gesture of mortified concealment. Whatever war-torn mishap had caused his burns, it also managed to incinerate Merlin's cynicism as he witnessed the man's loneliness, his fear of being rejected, his isolation and alienation, and it was just the same as the woman crippling along in high heels hoping to please the ubiquitous male gaze. It was just the same as the old braggart trying to convince others of his continued worth. It was just the same as the piggish child finding consolation in the company of cats. It was just the same as the transvestite demonstrating his identity to himself through the eyes of others. It was just the same as the driver fending his way through a hostile world, armed only with a defiant middle finger. It was just the same as the street preacher looking for truth in something that deceives as easily as words. It was just the same as the shallow young woman in dreadlocks seeking something more meaningful than materialism. It was just the same as the homeless man drowning his hopelessness in a bottomless bottle. It was just the same as the obese man nurturing himself with junk food. It was just the same as the douchebag distracting his existential terror with ambition. And it was just the same as Merlin's own contempt, trying to convince himself that he was different from all these other lost souls. It was all just the same. The same crying shame. The same dying game. And it was all Merlin could do not to fall madly in love with the world and all its fools.